All right, your Monday strength, we're gonna hit front squats and back squats. Now, in order to get the bar up, you do have to do a clean. So clean it to your shoulders. Front squats actually are gonna be first, Tarkin. So keep it in that front rack position. He's gonna do 6 front squats. Driving up with those elbows, screwing his feet into the ground as he drives up, squeezing his glutes as he drives out of the hole. And then after his last front squat, he's gonna give me a dip drive to get it in the back rack position where he's gonna do 6 back squats. Same thing, screw those feet into the ground, squeeze those glutes. And something else he's doing, he's taking a nice breath of air at the top. That's bracing his core, drawing his navel in towards his spine before he does that rep. After that, he's gonna give it a dip drive back to the front, and then he's going to put the bar down. He's then going to do 6 lateral lunges with no weight, trying to get as low as he can. Keeping that chest up is the name of the game. Don't bow forward like that. Keep that chest up as high as you can. So we're then going to go through another set, and it would be 5 front squats, 5 back squats, and your lateral lunges are going to stay 6 throughout. What you're going to notice is we're going to go down by 1 every single rep. And when we get to our 3 front squat, 3 back squat, your loop time is going to increase to 3 minutes at that point. Prior to it, it was on a 2-minute loop. So as things get heavier, we're going to give you more time to recover. You do have an active rest in there with 8 side shuffle touchdowns, just to, again, stay moving and keep you warm. Pick a distance, 10 feet or so, whatever you guys are working with, and just do 8 of them total. Again, just to keep you warm.
Good job, Sarah.